Well, I have another smartphone powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon 778G processor. Seems like this is the hottest chipset in the market right now. The one that I'm going to talk about today is the iQOO Z5. Now, this is priced at ₹24,000 for its base variant with 8GB of RAM, while the 12GB RAM variant comes at ₹27,000, which, by the way, is an excellent pricing for that sort of RAM. But where does this phone stand against the competition, the likes of Xiaomi 11 Lite NE 5G and the Realme GT Master Edition? And is this phone actually worth buying? Well, I'll try and tell you in this video. You're watching India Today Tech. I am Manas Tiwari and this is a review of iQOO Z5. Before I start this video, let me remind you once again that if you have been liking our content, please subscribe to India Today Tech. Also, tap on the bell icon next to the subscribe button so that whenever we upload these videos, you are the first one to get notifications. Now let's start a review of the iQOO Z5 with its design. The iQOO Z5 reminds me of some of Vivo smartphones from the past. When Vivo was launching all these mid-range smartphones, it focused a lot on the design and in-hand feel. And I think the iQOO Z5 carries that legacy, because if you can closely look here, this one comes with a rear panel which has a glittery and a sparkling finish, which looks good when light falls on it from different angles. This phone comes in two different color variants, Mystic Space and Arctic Dawn. Luckily, I had a chance to get my hands on both these variants, and I'll any day pick up this white one, which is a little more shiny. Thankfully, both these variants do not catch any fingerprint smudges. The camera module also looks nice. See, overall, iQOO hasn't tried to position this smartphone or design it any different from already existing mid-premium smartphones, and that shows. But despite that, it feels good in hand. It's not too heavy at 193 grams. And it's good enough for daily usage as well. You get a 3.5mm headphone jack on the top, a Type-C USB charging port at the bottom, and also the speaker grill is at the bottom right next to your charging port. Just like a lot of other mid-premium smartphones, the iQOO Z5 also comes with a side-mounted fingerprint scanner, which comes on top of your power button. And that confirms one more thing, that this phone does not come with an AMOLED display. And on that thought, let's talk about the display. The display on the iQOO Z5 is an LCD display, unlike the AMOLED panels that you now get on Xiaomi 11 Lite NE 5G and Realme GT Master Edition, both priced in the same price segment. Despite this, the display is good enough for your normal usage. Apart from that on-paper difference of LCD and AMOLED, you do not feel much of an issue in your daily usage. And this one also comes with 120Hz of refresh rate, but surprisingly, iQOO has gone with 240Hz of touch sampling rate. I think that could have been better. The colors look sharp on the screen and on point. They have a high contrast ratio, ensure deep blacks, and the brightness worked perfectly well in the brightest of days. The screen also comes with HDR10 support and Widevine L1 certification for HD content on OTT platforms like Netflix. Since this is a tall screen sitting at 6.67 inch, I think it's gonna make for a very good viewing experience if you stream a lot of content on your smartphone. It's the camera where the iQOO Z5 really struggles or fails to maintain consistency. I was in fact kind of surprised to see the difference between the images clicked by the main camera and all the other lenses. As for the setup, this phone comes with a triple rear camera system at the back, which includes a 64 megapixel main camera, an 8 megapixel ultra wide angle camera, and a 2 megapixel third lens. And you also get a 16 megapixel selfie shooter. Now coming to the image samples, if you can see these two images of stones, which I clicked during afternoon and in ideal light conditions, they look absolutely brilliant. They're in fact wallpaper worthy, and you can clearly see the amount of details and sharpness that have been captured by the main camera. I can also say the same for some of the wide shots taken by the main camera. They look really good. Similarly, if you look at this image of, which is a close-up shot of a tree's trunk, it looks really good. The details have been captured really well. Even if you zoom in, you can see that even the minute details have been captured really well by the main lens. Now, when you move to the ultra wide angle camera is where you start noticing the difference. The details are not captured the same way as they are on the main camera. The dynamic range is also not that great. And if you zoom in on the corners, you can see that the leaves are almost washed out. Even the trees in the center in the second image have not been captured really well, and they don't look pleasant. The camera really struggles in low light conditions. The images captured from a distance are still passable. You can also capture good wide shots in low light conditions using the night mode, but it's the close-up shots. For example, look at the same image of the same set of stones captured at night, and you can clearly see that the phone is exposed here. It fails to create similar kind of pictures in low light conditions. The same also goes for the selfies. The phone captures good selfies in daylight, but at night and in low light conditions, it struggles to give you similar sort of results. As I told you in the beginning that this phone comes with Qualcomm Snapdragon 778G processor. Now this can be bought in two different variants with either 8GB of RAM and 128GB of storage, or 12GB of RAM with 256GB of storage. Now I really find value in the 12GB RAM variant because I can't really think of any other smartphone which has a 12GB variant at this price. So if you do a lot of multitasking on your phone or play a lot of games, I think you should definitely go with the 12GB RAM variant. There's also a liquid vapor cooling system which keeps your phone cool while gaming, and honestly I played a few games on this phone and I did not face any issues in terms of heating and all. The irritating aspect of the iQOO Z5 though is the FunTouch OS 12 that it runs on. Now Vivo's operating system has improved a lot in the last few years, but this phone shows us there is still scope for a lot of improvement or changes. It's too crowded from the start. You get plenty of pre-installed apps on the phone, including Moj, MX Takatag, ShareChat, Daily Hunt, PhonePe, Cred, Byju's, and even Vivo's own hot apps and hot games. The pain point is that you cannot even uninstall some of these apps, and I have been saying this repeatedly. While it makes some sense on budget smartphones, a phone like this which costs you ₹27,000 should not have these many pre-installed apps. Now this phone comes with a 5000 mAh battery, which is I think good enough for most users. I was using this phone to click a lot of images, to play a few games, and for our general shooting purposes. And I managed to get about 1.5 days of battery life. Of course, that's not going to be possible if you have a continuously running SIM and mobile data on the phone. But then even then, you can expect this phone to last for at least a day. The iQOO Z5 has a lot of things going for it, and there are few which don't fall in its favor. For example, at ₹25,000, you are getting a good value for your money. You get a decent processor, an elegant design, a high refresh rate display, and a big battery. But on the other hand, you get a very annoying operating system and very inconsistent cameras as well. So if camera specifically is your preference, I would suggest you to pass this one and look at other options. But if you are after processor and performance, then definitely you can consider the iQOO Z5 at this price. Now coming to three things that we like. First has to be its elegant design. I think this phone still looks quite good. Second has to be the performance that you get on this phone. It's quite consistent. And third is the battery life. You get a decent battery here. Now three things that we did not like about the iQOO Z5. The first has to be the camera. In fact, I will break it into two different points. The first thing that we did not like is the ultra-wide angle camera on this phone. It's really poor. Second is the low-light photography. It's not up to the mark. And third thing is the software experience. There are too many pre-installed apps on this phone, and iQOO honestly needs to get rid of them. India Today Tech's rating for iQOO Z5 is 7 out of 10. I hope you find this video useful. Thank you for watching.